promise, no, I don't back down. Leave your heart laying on the ground. Tell me who to kill it now. Tell me who to kill it now. Hello, 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 my stars and galaxies. Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back to my channel, The Universe Tarot. And today, okay, we're doing a reading for Aries. Aries, it's all about you. It's all about the Aries today, okay? Before we get started, though, make sure you guys like the video, share the video, subscribe, please, and make sure you hit that post notification bell so you don't miss an upload for when I upload. And, like, for real, guys, really make sure that you turn on that that bell, because YouTube is going on with some crap, okay? There's people I'm subscribed to that got millions of subscribers, and their views is like 66,000, 70,000 views, and it's been like a full 10 hours, and that's the result. Like, come on, like it's crazy, y'all. So please make sure that you really look out for my videos if you can. You know what I'm saying? I really appreciate it. It's because, you know, support a growing channel, okay? And yeah, that's basically it. If you want a personal reading, okay? If you want a personal reading, my Instagram, my TikTok, my business phone number, my TikTok, my what you call it? See, now there's more things added to it, so I forgot. Right? All right, no, I got it. Okay, my Instagram, my business phone number, and my TikTok. Okay, it's all down there now. Okay, I think I forgot to put the link in the previous video, the one that's 40 minutes long. I forgot to put it in there, but that's okay. I'll add it in there. But yeah, but like for real, like, you know, if you guys wanna, I wanna apologize for any noise as well, okay? Cause it's like when I'm ready to do a reading, there's noise around me. So I so sorry if you hear any noise like that just now, or you know, just anything, okay? I apologize, okay? Cause now I'm trying to be productive. People making noise around me. Okay, but yeah, if you want a personal reading, those are your options, okay? Where is my, oh, I don't even have it. I don't even have my cards. Hold on, y'all. There you go. I still had it in a plastic bag from when I was doing my personal, not my personal, my car reading, if you guys saw the video, right? So yeah, please just like the video, share, subscribe if you can. I really, really appreciate it. I really, really need it, okay? So we're just gonna go ahead. I know I took up enough time already, so we're just gonna go ahead and get started, right? Aries, I hope you're having a good morning, noon, and night. I hope all is well. But if all is not well, I do apologize. Hopefully your situation will get better. Everybody, hopefully my reading will help your situation get better. But either way, I do hope it gets better. Okay. Let's see. All right. Okay. We're gonna move this up a little bit more. Okay. Okay, ready, y'all? So let's see. We're gonna flip this first row. Okay. You are the best thing in my life. Okay. You are the best thing in my life. Okay. So this person is reminiscing about how much you were like probably like the healthiest, like the healthiest partner that they ever had, or the best relationship they ever had. You know, and maybe you guys broke up because, you know, things were not working out. Maybe they weren't treating you the way you deserved. Okay. Or they felt like, you know, you couldn't give them what they needed in the relationship. Okay. Right. Maybe they. Oh, I thought I heard something. But yeah, maybe they just thought the grass would have been greener somewhere else. Okay? That's probably what they thought. Maybe they thought, oh, yeah, I can get somebody else who's better. Right? You know? So now they're just like, I wonder if you are happy without me. Okay? Like I said, so much reminiscing. Okay? There's so much reminiscing. Hold on, there's a noise. Wait.
Okay, so I thought it was my phone, but it was actually my dog downstairs. I'm sorry, y'all. Like I said, noises around me all of a sudden. It was quiet all day, I promise. But yeah, they wonder if you're happy, okay, without them. You probably are, because Aries, you know exactly how to move on from people who are stressing you out. You know exactly, you don't let people, you know, stay in your life and stress you out and make your life hell. Okay? So you know how to move on. You know how to progress, okay? You know how to progress and, you know, go on about your day. Okay? That's what you're good at. Okay? You know how to handle that, right? But, you know, they might feel like they're trying to tell themselves or convince themselves, like, how they probably miss me, but I ain't just saying it, right? But you probably are, but Aries, you probably are happy without them, okay? Because you know what? Breaking up with somebody, right, isn't even a bad thing, okay? When you break up, when you separate with somebody who's not treating you right or not putting in the same energy into the relationship, it's easier to forget them, okay? Because it's just like you weren't missing out on anything, right? So it's all right. Like, Aries, you're all right. Now, but see, they're the ones that's getting killed right now because so many things remind me of you. Okay? So many things remind me of you. Everything that they do, everything that they look at, it reminds them of the time that they spent with you. Okay? Now, personally, I feel like if they have if only they had had this energy at the time you guys were dating, okay, it would have been better, okay? But now they're reminiscing now, because now they probably realize how much it hurts without you in their life, okay? So, you know, this is really their fault. This is really their problem. This is really something that they're going to have to work out, because you had to work it out when you were separating with, like, separating from them, okay? They didn't care if, you know, you were struggling to move on, or, you know, if you were having a hard time, or if you were having dark thoughts, like, stuff like that, okay? Or either they didn't care, or they just didn't know enough to care, or didn't care enough to know, excuse me, right? Right? More potato, potato, right? So still, that's just how they, you know, just went about their day. They just went about their day like that, okay? I lost myself for a while, okay? I lost myself for a while. You know, honestly, that's what they get. Okay? Honestly, that's what they get. Right? If that's what they want to do, okay? And if that's, like, if they are starting to have regrets in their actions, if they're starting to have, like, you know, what is it called? If they're starting to kind of regret the choices that they made, good. Because that will show them, right? Don't bite the hand that feeds you. Do not bite the hand that feeds you. Don't bite the hand that takes care of you or looks out for you or treats you right. Okay? For real. You don't bite the hand that feeds you. You don't let people, what you call it, just run over you like that, okay? And this person couldn't do that with you, okay? Because you're on a different level, Aries, right? You're on a different level. You don't deserve that kind of treatment. You know, they are actually getting their karma, okay? I hid behind material things, okay? So maybe they were worried about the stuff that you could do, what you could do for them, right? They're more worried about what you could do for them in the relationship rather than what kind of personality you had or how caring you were or how this and that you were. And that didn't matter. None of that mattered. They wanted to know what you can bring to them. Okay? That's what they want. That is what they want. They want you to be the provider. They want you to be the caregiver, whatever the hell that they want, right? That is what they're looking for. Right? Let's see what else we got. Okay. Let's see if we can get more detail. More details. More details in this, okay? All right, so the Eight of Swords, okay? this didn't do much help for your mental health. Okay? Not really. If anything, you were always caught up in your own head. Like, oh, maybe I'm not doing enough. Or why are they acting like this? Why are they being like this? Da, 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 da. Like, you are mentally troubled. Like, you cannot get a moment's peace in the Eight of Swords. Right? But Aries, you are already doing enough. You are doing more than enough. It's just that this person wasn't appreciative in that moment where y'all were together. Now, the Ace of Pentacles in the reverse, right? There was not going to be any golden light out of this relationship. Even if you guys tried and tried, you know, only one person is going to try. And that's going to be you. Because you're always trying and they didn't even seem to try, right? Because with that, because of the Four of Wands in the reverse, ain't no happy celebration, ain't no getting serious in the relationship, ain't no marriage one day between the two of y'all. No. Right? Ain't nothing like that with y'all. Okay? Because your energies don't click. Your energies don't make this possible. Your energies together don't make this possible to move forward in something. Okay? And that's their fault, not you, because they could be serious. They could take the relationship seriously, but they weren't. Okay? Now you got the Fool in the reverse. Okay? Maybe you feel like you were the one that got played. You know, maybe they liked you first, right? But you're the one that still got played. Or maybe you should have seen, or maybe you felt like you should have seen the signs, right? But you kind of ignored the signs, right? But you know what, Aries? You live and learn. I wouldn't be so hard on yourself. I mean, most of us have been there at one point. You know, don't be so hard on yourself. You know, just really just keep an eye out next time. If you're, you know, really just keep an eye out next time. You know, and just really don't, just really just like, what can I say? Really just don't let anyone treat you like that, okay? Or barely, like, put the bare minimum in your relationship, okay? Because relationship is always going to be a 50-50 thing, right? Now, with the Five of Cups in the reverse, okay? They have regrets, okay? Not you, okay? They are the ones that have regrets, not you, okay? Now, you'll probably feel like, oh, you shouldn't have wasted your time on this person. Right, maybe, probably not true, but you know what? You live and learn. Okay? You live and learn, okay? And don't feel too bad. Yeah, you made a mistake. Yeah, you made a mistake. Wasted your time with this person, but you know, F them, honestly. Okay? F them. You know, everyone goes through stuff like this, right? So, it's just really important not to go through it again. Really look out for the signs in the future. Okay, let's see what else we got. I don't react when people mention you. Ooh. Right? I don't react when people mention you. You're over this person. Okay? You don't react. You don't care. Right? You don't care. You're over it. Okay? Because the reason why is because this person's no longer on your level. They're not on your level. Okay? They're not on your level. You are trying to elevate, okay? And this person is so irrelevant, right? Transparent, that you don't even care about what they do or what they say, you know, because you are on a different level from them, okay? You know now, Aries, that you deserve better, and you deserve somebody who has the same level of energy that they're going to put in the relationship, and you don't want to accept anyone less. I wish I could share my good news with you, right? They wish they could tell you stuff like, oh, I want to get back together, or, you know, I just landed a new job, or, you know, I really miss talking to you all this time. They wish they could, you know, just anything, just whatever is on their mind, they wish they could say to you, but they can't because y'all are not in contact, okay? They miss you to death, okay? They miss you to death, right? And they so desperately want you. Okay? They miss you and they want you to forgive them. I hope you can forgive me one day. Right? I hope you can forgive me one day. Mm-hmm. They make it so obvious, right? And nothing's wrong with forgiving them, right? But as far as being in long-term contact, that's not really going to happen. That's less likely to happen because maybe you already found somebody better, or maybe you're just on a better track or pathway to where you want to be in life. Maybe you're just doing better for yourself. You don't want no one else in your life, or you just don't want them in your life, okay? And that's fine, you know? That's fine. You don't want them in your life. That's fine. That's your choice. All right? And you just feel like you're on a different level from them and they don't need to have any kind of connection with you. All right? You don't know how hard it was to let you go. Right? This could, I actually really feel like this one is from you. Okay? Like maybe at first it hurt to let you go, you know, because you really wanted the relationship to work. Maybe you really wanted something from the relationship. You really tried and did your best. Okay? You know, so it took you a while to get over them. And maybe, like, you know, now you flossing on them, Aries. But back then, maybe it was harder to get over them because you really wanted something. You really tried your best with this relationship. You really hoped for something more. Or, you know, for them, now they're understanding how much hell it was for you. Okay? And now they feel like it's hard to mentally let you go. Okay? And now they know they messed everything up. Okay? They know they messed up everything. They know they effed up, okay? But you know what? That sounds like a personal problem, okay? Honestly. Because Aries, if they want your forgiveness, they're going to have to earn it, right? And even if they do get your forgiveness, that doesn't mean you need to stay associated with them. That doesn't mean y'all need to stay in contact. That just means you forgive them, and that way you both can let go. You both can focus on other things. You guys can just, you know, grow from this experience. Okay? Because when you're in a relationship, right, that person's already supposed to give you, you know, the respect and love that you deserve. That's how you get in the relationship in the first place. If that person doesn't respect you the first time, what was the point of being in the relationship at all, right? That's why a lot of times, sometimes I don't even think it's necessary for second chances. Because it's just like the first time should have been all the chances, okay? But, you know, everybody's different. But like I said, you know, you just got, like, as far as respect and being humble in the relationship goes, you deserve all the respect, okay? Because at the end of the day, you were doing your best to keep the relationship going, right? So make sure you get that same amount of respect, Aries, right? Also, I have another video playing after this. It's 40 minutes long. It's 40 minutes long. It has an Aries reading in it, and it has a compilation, however you say it, of collective TikTok readings, right? So collective readings, right? Now, I posted that video separately, okay? But it did not get the views that I was hoping for. It did not get my usual views. So, wow. So I'm going to put it in this one, okay? I thought maybe it would have been better to do a reading and then add it on there. But so please, guys, really stick around, watch it. You know, I really appreciate it. Let's support a growing channel, you know what I'm saying? If you already watched it from start to finish, then okay, you're fine. You get a free pass. But, you know, if you haven't watched it, you know, please stick around. Please. All right? So I'll see you guys in the next one. All right? Stick around, please. You never know if it might resonate with you. This has been the Universe Tarot. Namaste. Rest, no, I don't back down. Leave your heart laying on the ground. Tell me who to kill it now. Tell me who to kill it. Hello, 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 my stars and galaxies. Welcome back to my channel, The Universe Tarot. And today, this particular part, is not a reading. Alright, I just put in a little intro, a little explanation before, you know, I added in the long part. You're probably wondering, like, wow, if this is not a reading, why is it so long? Well, it is readings, plural, mixed together. The first couple of videos that you're going to see are actually TikTok videos. Okay, they're actually TikTok videos. So, you know, I just thought, oh, why not just add it in there with my pre-recorded videos? So, like, because I have a pre-recorded video. So what I'm going to do is, like, kind of, like, put TikTok videos in the front, you know, so something new. And then, like, the pre-recorded video, you know, some of y'all probably already seen it. But, you know, I'm going to put that one last. It's like a half an hour video. I don't know how long this video is going to be after I put the TikTok videos in there. Probably like 40 minutes, almost 40 maybe, because it's like multiple. But yeah, that's what I'm going to do. You know, so, you know, enjoy. Okay. The TikTok videos are general readings, like collective readings. right? Depending on how I typed it in the TikTok videos, okay? But yeah, it's still a collective reading. So it doesn't matter what your zodiac sign is, okay? It just, you can just take it how, if it resonates with you. If it resonates with you, that's super duper dandy, okay? If it doesn't, well, I'm sorry, okay? But yeah, that's just how that's gonna go. I just wanna let you guys know that, right? I just wanna let you guys know that before you be like, hey, what is going on here? Da, 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 da. Right? So yeah. And, you know, that's basically it. So, I hope you guys like the video. Still, share the video. Subscribe and hit that post notification bell so you don't miss an upload when I upload, right? If you want a personal reading, hit me up. You know, contact information is down there. I put the link to my TikTok in the description box below for those who couldn't reach it or couldn't find it. I feel like a lot of y'all should be able to find it now because, you know, now I have followers. So now if you type in my username correctly, you should be able to find it. But for those who still have a hard time finding it, don't worry. I will put the link in the description box of this video and going forward with all the other videos, okay? So no one will have any frustration, okay? Then, yeah, that's basically that. Yeah, I guess that's it. So, yeah, you know, membership's available, blah, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying? Like, so if you guys want to hop over and go follow my TikTok, that'll be great, okay? And, you know, just show love, like, show, share the love. You know, whatever y'all want to do, okay? But, y'all, I appreciate it either way, okay? So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. All right, have fun. Please welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. Or just welcome to my tarot channel, okay? My tarot account. Thank you guys so much for being able to find me. Thank you guys for following, okay? Let's see what we got for Aries. This is an Aries quick short read today, okay? One, okay, two, three. Let's see what you got. Okay, so you got the Three of Cups in the reverse. Okay, so with Three of Cups in the reverse, you're going to be ditching some fake ass folk, total people that's not having your back, not caring about you. They are being fake. They don't care nothing about you. They're not showing you any love. They don't show anything real with you. Okay, now you got the Page of Swords. It's okay to be solo. Page of Swords, you're gonna have to go solo, move on solo, do your own thing solo. It's okay to be solo. Nothing's wrong with being solo. You know, it's okay to be solo and just love yourself and find your own purpose. Okay, now with Queen of Cups, you're flawless. You can do it. You don't need nobody. You can get it. You can floss on these motherfuckers and you can just go ahead and go with it. Okay, woo.
Love the chase and the hunt, and I set the pace when I'm running. I always take what I want and I always give it 100. Don't need a bank, no, I'm funded. Play the game like it's nothing. I'm always thankful for something. Don't take for granted, stay humble. Now wake up, it's time to look at the enemy. Look in the mirror if he is no friend to me. It's not working out, maybe it's the chemistry. It's time to break up so I can make a better me. Better believe in your mind, cause it's everything. You can mold, shape, find almost anything. All it takes.
It's at 5 in the morning. I wake up to 5 for my yearnings. Fear in my mind is a warning. Pray to the one you're relying. I've been wandering all day. I tried to be fine, but I can't be. The noise in my mind wouldn't leave me. I tried to get by, but I'm burning.
Sit by myself, talking to the moon.
Fill up the single turn up. Yeah, yeah. Pull up the single turn up. Yeah, yeah.
In the mirror, so foggy, but I've never seen clearer. I don't really think anyone can save me, and honestly, I'm not really sure I want saving. I like to be my own worst enemy. There's no risk if you don't try at anything, so I'ma just keep buying everything. See you in the next life, hope to be a better me. I don't think that my head's on straight. Gotta flip it and grip it and go and get an x-ray. What's wrong with me? I just feel weight pushing on my chest and it squeezes till I suffocate. Better change my mindset, meditate. It's pretty cool that I'm alive and have better days. I could walk, see, hear, I should celebrate. Think I could change my mind, maybe elevate. Living life.
Today, we are doing a reading for Aries. Aries, it's all about you. It's all about the Aries today. Before we get started, make sure you guys like the video, share the video, subscribe, and hit that post notification bell so you don't miss an upload when I upload, alright? Please note that the Tarot Instagram page is in the description box below, along with my Cash App and PayPal, so you know exactly where to go if you're ready for your personal reading. Okay? Everything you need to know is down there. I have to say this for the new people that's, you know, on my page. So if you're new, you're totally new, like I said, business phone number, business Instagram, phone, Cash App, PayPal, all down there. Okay, if you need it. Okay. And yeah. Now, membership, okay. Membership is available. Okay, if you're interested enough to join the membership, you know, join the membership and just get the VIP perks, you know, anything that you're interested in, and et cetera, et cetera. Okay, just anything that you're interested in, if you're interested in getting it and, you know, getting, you know, treatment that nobody else gets. Okay? All right. So, let's see. Is there anything else? Oh, yeah. If you do want a personal reading, if there's ever like a time you do want a personal reading, just make sure that you're not sending money before actually, you know, setting up your appointment. Okay? Make sure you set up your appointment first. Okay, that's the first thing that you're supposed to do. Set up your appointment first, okay? And then send payment, okay? It's really just for both people's safety. You know, make sure that you guys don't just, you know, accidentally do it, or, you know, make sure that you guys, you know, stay smart on the internet, whatever case is, right? I mean, obviously I'm not a scammer because scammers don't usually have a YouTube video, but, or a YouTube channel, but, you know, still, you know, just really, just keep that in mind, okay? You know, it also remembers who, it helps me remember who is who, so, yeah, you know, so let's just do that, okay? I guess that is basically it. Yeah, that's basically it. So I hope everyone's having a good morning, noon, and night. I hope all is well. Okay? But if all is not well, I really, really do apologize. Okay? Hopefully your day will get better. Your situation will get better. Or, you know, maybe my reading will help a situation get better. Okay? All right. I'm gonna take a sip of my iced tea. Mm-hmm. It's not even ice. It's more like sweet tea. All right. So, Aries. Okay? Aries. I'm trying to figure out what deck I want to use. We'll use this one first. All right. Now, honestly, I'm not gonna lie. I didn't mix these very well. I didn't turn these very well. Because some of them are face side up in the deck, but that's okay. You know, that's a whatever. It's whatever. Okay? Whatever. Okay, so what is this? All right? We got Inner Trust. Okay? Legacy of Light. All right? Inner Trust, Legacy of Light. Let's see what else. Since we're here. Okay. Now, Inner Trust, right? Legacy of Light. Okay. The word wants to be written. Okay. The word wants to be written. What do you feel? Okay. And releasing you know what, you guys can say that word for yourself. I was gonna say alliances. No, it's not even alliances, whatever. God, all right, this is my first time using this goddamn thing, but anyway, right? Inner Trust. Okay, this is more so being able to trust yourself than trust other people. Maybe whether or not you have a problem like learning to trust other people, it's really important that you are able to trust yourself. Okay, that is the important thing here. You need to be able to trust yourself always. Okay, because the problem with that is like if you don't trust yourself to be able to make the smart decisions, the hard decisions, etc., and you're over here letting people make it for you, or you're not making any decisions at all, you're showing people that you have a weak institution here, where you can't even do anything by yourself, you know, without help. Okay, you absolutely need help 24/7. You can't even function without someone just, you know, making the decision for you. Okay. Like, it's still important, Aries, that you are able to guide yourself at least once in a while, okay? That's the only thing. Being able to guide yourself once in a while. I'm not saying anything's wrong with getting help from somebody who is willing to help you, right? But there's going to be times in your life, Aries, where no one can help you. You have to figure it out yourself, okay? That's the thing that's the thing I mean. You have to figure it out yourself. You have to be able to, you know, work out your own situations. Okay, you have to be able to work out your own situations and be able to at least do some individual thinking. Okay, now with Legacy of Light, okay, you're just trying to find your way. Okay, you're just somehow trying to find your way through the darkness of this world. Okay, through the dark situations, through the I think that is alliances. I'm sorry, I got distracted, but anyway, right. You're just trying to find your way. You're just trying to find your own path. Okay. You're just trying to find what makes you happy, what makes you content. Okay. Makes you feel comfortable in the position that you're in your purpose. Okay. Let's just say that your purpose. You're trying to find your purpose. You're trying to find what makes you happy. And if this is something that, you know, you can be confident enough in. Okay. That's something that you're looking for, right? All of us want to be comfortable. All of us want to be confident in whatever we're doing, okay? It is always important to be confident and be able to walk with your head up high, and that, you know, and you're just like, oh, you know what? I can do this, right? We out here. We can do this, okay? That's the best thing to say, to be able to have confidence in what you're doing, or just even being able to wake up in the morning, okay? Like, it's always important to have confidence in yourself and have confidence in just getting to where you want to be, okay? You're always going to need confidence in yourself, Aries, because if you don't have confidence in yourself, you can forget about trying to excel in life, okay? The word wants to be written, okay? Maybe you will think a lot, right? Maybe, Aries, you think a lot. You know, you're always conjuring up some thoughts in your head, okay? But see, the problem is that maybe whatever you say doesn't become reality. Like, say, for example, like, oh, I want to be doing this by the time it's the summer of next year. Like, say, for example, you want to be a doctor by the summer of next year. You know, so you're trying all these things. You're trying to do all these things to become a doctor. You're trying to go to school, do this, do that, right? But, and then the time finally comes and you're still not where you want to be. Okay, so you feel sad because you can't get to where you want. Okay, but see, Aries, that's the thing though. As long as you're willing to stick with it, okay, that is the important thing. Being able to stick with it and just, you know, go with it and just keep going, keep trying, you know, don't feel discouraged over the littlest thing. That's the important part, okay. That is the important part. Being able to push through everything, being able to conquer any insecurities, being able to just keep going, even though if it feels like, you know, it's not working, okay? That's the important thing. That is what you need to be doing, okay? It's okay if you're not quite where you want to be, okay? It's okay if you're not, like you know, doing what you want specifically. It's okay. You know, you still have time, right? And as long as you're willing to work and keep going and you're trying and you're going to go ahead and make those sacrifices to where you want to be, it will happen, okay? But it definitely won't happen if you give up on yourself, okay? You can forget about that. Oh, if you give up on yourself and you say, oh, God, I quit this damn thing, fine. You know, that's the decision you made. But let me tell you something. You're going to miss out on the reward, right? If you actually get there. No, excuse me. When you actually get there, okay? Because no one ever got to where they wanted by giving up, okay? Just look at every history event in America. You think people got where they wanted to be or got the change that they wanted by giving up? Nope. They worked to what they wanted, okay? So you can't give up on yourself. You have to keep going to make sure that you can succeed. Now, what do you feel, right? What do you feel? What makes you feel so helpless? What makes you feel like, you know, there's no point? What makes you feel like, what does a certain thing make you feel, right? What do you feel after confessing to that crush at work? Or what do you feel after, you know, finally getting a promotion? Or what do you feel after finally losing 20 pounds? Right? Just anything. What do you feel after, you know, insert accomplishment here? Okay? Now, if you can't think of an accomplishment, okay? What do you feel since you're not there? Okay? Right? Now, take that feeling, right? And use it as your motivation, okay? Say, for example, oh, I'm sad because I'm not rich. Okay, fine. You're being honest about how you feel. You know, you're admitting that it's not a good feeling to, you know, sit there and be broke. Okay, fine. You know, you're sad that I'm sad that I'm not rich. But, okay, but I can't just moan and cry about how I'm not rich. I need to do something. So, okay, I'm sad I'm not rich. But here's what I'm going to do. Starting tomorrow, I'm going to start... I'm going to start, you know, looking for high-paying jobs. You know, something. Okay? It's important to acknowledge how you feel, whether it's good or bad, right? But if it's bad, okay? If it's bad, what can we do to change it? What can you... And don't say nothing. There's nothing I can do to change it. There's always something you can do to change it. Okay? Something you can do, okay? We're humans. We can do anything. Okay, maybe we can't fly like a bird with our own two hands, but you know, we are capable of thriving, okay? And there has been times where we are able to change the probability of something, okay? So you need to go ahead and just claim it. Just go ahead and do it, right? Don't worry about what could go wrong. Think about what could go right, all right? Now, I think this is alliances, okay? I think I was right, yeah. I don't know why. I don't know why I looked at it like, well, what is this word? I think, yeah, releasing alliances. Because at first I was going to say allegiances. But I'm just like, no, I was right. Alliances. Okay? So, yeah, releasing alliances. Okay? That really means, like, you know, just releasing negative people in your life. Right, just people who have not had your back, or have not really cared about what you're doing, who have not really cared about, you know, your success in life, haven't really been rooting you on. Like, you gotta get rid of people who are unnecessary in your life. Get rid of the unnecessary people. Okay? That will do you some good. Okay? That will do you some good. Get rid of the annoying people in your life. Okay? The people who don't do anything for you or where you need to be, okay? And if you have anybody like that in your life, separate yourself from them as much as possible, okay? Because now they are cluttered up space. They are cluttered up space, so you deserve way more, okay? You deserve real people who are going to support you, care about you, you know, root you on, etc., etc., okay? And you don't need people in your life who are going to try to get something out of you. Like, say, for example, you're starting to make that real money, you're starting to really make that real bank. So all of a sudden, people start crowding in and start asking you for money and help them out with a bill and da da da. If somebody's going to do that to you, make sure that they have helped you out in serious times. Okay, like say for example, Aries, I ask you to help me with a bill. Like, give me some money so I can pay my light bill. Okay. Before you give me that light bill money, was there any point in time where you were struggling with money and I helped you, or you know, you needed some place to stay, or you just needed a shoulder to cry on, da da da, right? If you can think of one moment at least, okay, go ahead. But if you can't think of a moment, don't bother. Okay? You only give to people who have given to you. Or have gave to you. I don't know. I'm not a grammar teacher. Okay? But yeah. Still. Only give to people who have given you that. Yeah. I'm saying given. It's probably gave, but I'm saying given. But yeah. Who have, like, you know, returned that energy in the first place. If not, don't bother. Because some people will make you be like, oh, I thought we were cool. I thought we were friends, okay? And you'll be like, y'all could be cool. Y'all could be cool, right? But they can't be no bum, no slouch off of your hard-earned, you know, whatever. Okay? They can join the club and, you know, work for what they want, right? But you just got to release negative tension, negative people who have never done anything for you. F them, okay? Honestly. Now, we're going to flip this second row. These guys are really pretty. I'm not going to lie. Okay? Whew. Heaven sent. Okay? Heaven sent. Right? So, maybe you've been like, wait. I'm going to sip this real quick. Sip my sweet tea. It's so good. It's Milo sweet tea, in case you're wondering. The extra sweet tea. Anyway. Yeah, so heaven sent, right? You are a rare, that basically means you're a rare person. You're rare, okay? You're one of those people who are, you know, just really hardworking, really strong and kind. You know, you do the best that you can. You know, you don't mess around with other people. You know, you actually just worry about yourself and keep it pushing, okay? You worry about yourself and keep it pushing. You know, you do your own thing. You do the best that you can every day, right? And whether or not that goes unappreciated, well, whether or not that's appreciated, right? As long as you appreciate it. Okay? Just as long as you appreciate it. That's all that matters. Okay? And actually, no. Hopefully, people who don't appreciate the stuff that you do will not ask you for anything. But that's probably just wishful thinking. Okay? Because, you know, you're so pure, Aries. You're so pure. You're so true. You're a real person. You know, you're not the kind of conniving, you know, person that only wants from people. You know, you actually care about people. You actually care about what they're, how they're doing. You actually care about, you know, what's going on in your life. You're not just looking for something, okay? You're not just asking all that stuff because you're getting ready to ask, you know, ask for something. You actually just care about a person's health. Okay? Right? You are just rare, right? And that's why you got that card, Heaven Sent, okay? Because there's not enough people like you. Yeah, there's a lot of people like you, right? But not enough, okay? Yeah, there's, you got people out there who are just like genuine and kind and proud and just do their own thing. And there's a couple, right? But not enough. You can never have enough of those kinds of people. So you're Heaven Sent. You're one of those real ones, because you got some real evil ass people who just want to fight and argue and steal and lie and cheat and bum off of other people, right? So you are one of the Heaven Sent ones. Dream a beautiful dream, okay? Always dream a beautiful dream, okay? Your dreams are never too big, okay? Your dreams are never too big. You can, no matter how big the dream is, you can achieve it if you keep going. Okay? You can achieve it. You can get to it. You can get there. No matter what you're trying to do, you can and will get there. Okay? You just got to be patient with yourself. Be patient with time. And be patient in general. Okay? Because everything that you want, everything that you want to just see in yourself, it will happen. Okay? It will happen, right? It's really just being patient and just keep in this worrying about your grind. Don't worry about, oh, how long it's going to take and this and that. Just go ahead. Just keep going, right? Because when you finally open your eyes, Aries, you're going to be so thankful that you kept going and you didn't give up. Okay, because there's going to be a lot of things in life that's going to try to F you up and make you give up, make you be like, oh, what's the point anymore, right? But I swear, do not let that happen, okay? Now we got conscious connections. All right, conscious connections, okay? Maybe you have these strange dreams, okay? When you sleep and you go to bed, and you have these dreams, maybe you have sometimes they're weird, you know, like you remember it up until the point where you wake up or you're about to start your day. You just have these weird dreams. Maybe you have people who are deceased. You used to, you know, talk to them all the time, right? Maybe they're no longer with us, right? You know, but, you know, you have these strange dreams, okay? And they sometimes speak messages to you. Maybe they have like little meanings and stuff like that in it. You know, maybe like people you used to talk to back in the day, right? But they're no longer with us. But you see them in your dreams. They could be your mom, dad, old friend, whoever. Right? Brother, sister, okay? Just whoever it is, right? But that's the kind of thing. See, that's the thing. With dreams, it connects us, right? To something a little bit more spiritual, okay? Now, some of y'all might not believe me, but it's true, okay? The thing with dreams, okay? When our body goes limp, dreams is basically our brain heading out the door, okay? Heading out the door, right? Our dreams can mean a lot of things, right? But when you see, but when you feel like your dreams have more connection than it shows, that means it does. Okay? So, next time you dream, Aries, and you feel like your dream is a little bit more real, it's like a little surreal, right? Just try to remember as much as you can. Try to just make, just kind of like connect the dots. Okay? Because maybe that's somebody trying to give you a message. Okay? I'm serious. I'm dead ass. I'm serious. Because, like I said, dreams release our bodies into a more spiritual sense of the world. Okay? Whether it's crazy or if it's a normal ass dream, whatever. Okay? Our dreams take us so far out of the mind, can take us to any kind of different reality. So you gotta, come on, like, our brains are always doing something different. So you gotta admit that your dreams can mean anything else. Okay? Against the grain. Okay? Now, when against the grain, right? Maybe you operate differently compared to everybody else. Okay? Maybe you do things differently, you say things differently. Not anything like rude to like disrespectful anybody, you know, something like that. You know, you just do things differently, okay? And that's not bad, okay? That's not always a bad thing, right? Mm. Sorry, it's so good. But yeah, that doesn't mean it's a bad thing, right? That just means that you're not the kind of person who's always following the crowd, seeing what the crowd is doing, the posse, you know, whatever. You do things at your own time, your own time scale, okay? Or you just do it different, okay? And that's okay. That's all you, okay? You do things in your own difference. That just expresses your individuality, okay? Now, not everyone's going to be like, not everyone's going to appreciate that, but F what people think, honestly, okay? F what people think, right? If they don't like you, then, all right, you don't have to like them back, okay? You do not have to like them back, F them. If they don't appreciate you as a person, they don't like you as a person, they don't like how you're different, fine, okay? And I mean this, I mean this in every different situation, in, you know, life, like just socially or career or love life, you know, just whatever. Okay? If they don't appreciate how creative or how different you are, then okay, whatever. You know, they don't have to be associated with you. Okay? They do not need to be associated with you, and they don't have to like you. Okay? They don't have to be around you, and that sounds like a personal problem. Okay? But let me tell you something right now, Aries. Just as long as you stay humble and true to yourself, right? Trust me, you're going to find a whole bunch of other friends. You're going to find a whole bunch of other people like you. And they're all trying to elevate. So that way y'all can help each other elevate. Okay? It's good that you're not with everybody else. You're not in that little posse group. Or you're not, you know, the follow the leader kind of person. You know, you want to be your own leader. Okay? And I respect that. Okay? I respect that. Okay? Because you are going to be somebody who's really going to pop out from the crowd, okay? You're going to pop out and you're going to stand out in the best way possible. Defend to the end the worthwhile. Okay? Now, this is basically meaning when you have people who have always had your back, you got to put in the same energy, okay? When you've had, like, say, for example, you've had friends who always, you know, stood by you, family members that always stood by you, right? So if they need, like, you know, someone to stand by them, that basically means to stand by the ones who stood by you, okay? Because Aries, remember, we can't get, you know, support and love from people if we're not giving support and love, okay? That's not going to work. We have to give back to get back and get back to give back, right? It's an endless cycle, you know? You give to somebody, make sure that they give you the same energy. If not, never again, okay? But it's always going to be important when you have people in your life and they are going through it right now and they need help. Always make sure that you can support them back if they need it, okay? Because you don't want to be labeled as that one-sided person who just takes, right? So when you have people in your life who have stood by you and had your back, and even in toughest times, make sure that you can give back that same energy. All right? Woo! All right? All righty, righty, righty. Now I'm going to go ahead and going to flip some business cards. Ugh, I don't even have business cards, so I don't even know why I'm saying that. I'm going to flip some bonus cards is what I meant to say. Okay, how much time do I have left? Oh, okay. I have time. All right, we're just going to go ahead, okay, and flip I keep saying business cards. Alright, bonus cards, y'all. Bonus cards. Oh, shoot. Okay, shoot. Wait, is this three? No, it's not. Okay, one more. I thought a three just fell out just like that, but it was really just two. Alright, so three bonus cards. Okay, I keep saying business. What the hell? Okay. So, bonus cards for this last reading. Knight of Swords. Okay, chase after what you want. Okay, chase after. Don't ever stop chasing for what you want, for what you want to see yourself. Because don't you want to see yourself get there, Aries? Right? Whatever it is that you want to be, don't stop chasing. Keep the chase. Never stop chasing after whatever it is. As corny as it probably sounds, don't stop chasing, okay? With the Justice card in the reverse, right? You probably feel like the world is against you sometimes. You always feel like maybe, you're just trying to do what you need to do to get ahead in life. And you feel like maybe the world is just like, oh, please. Well, who are you trying to be somebody, right? You probably feel like, things are unfair, okay? You feel like sometimes life is unfair. You feel like you can't, like, as good as a person you are or as heartbreaking as you are, you can't get to where you need to be, right? Life is always going to be unfair. It's not just for you, Aries. It's going to be for everybody else on this earth, right? But life is always going to be unfair no matter what we do, okay? All we can do is just be like, oh, my God, this sucks. And then, just really move on, right? Acknowledge that it sucks, all right? And then find something else to, kind of make up for it, okay? Now, with the Ten of Wands, right, in the reverse, you're always tired, okay? But you're trying to break away from the same old, okay? You're tired of always being the one to hold it together. You're tired of always, feeling down and out, right? So maybe you want to just change it up. Maybe you want to feel happy. Maybe you want to feel something, okay? And that's okay. You want to feel something. You want to do something different. You're tired of doing the same old thing and holding in all your emotions and stuff like that together. That's fine. You need to break away from the same old routine. Do whatever else that makes you happy. Do whatever it is that makes you happy. Whatever makes you feel content, right? And if you don't, and don't hold in your emotions. Okay, one of the worst things you can do is holding your emotions. Show your emotions so people will know that you're not feeling well, or if you're not happy, or if you're really sad. Just whatever you're feeling. Okay, whatever you're feeling, just go ahead. Just go ahead and let it out. Make people know it. Okay, and just don't hide away from who you are as a person. Okay, or who you're going to develop into. Okay, so Aries, I hope this did resonate with you. I hope this helped in any way. I hope this brought knowledge or enlightenment. But if this did not resonate with you, I do apologize. Hopefully the next Aries reading will. But in the meantime, though, make sure you guys like the video, share the video, subscribe, and hit that post notification bell so you don't miss an upload for an upload, all right? This has been the Universe Tarot. Namaste.